I was supposed to be born in the Rockefeller family. I think I was misplaced at birth.
His beard is long and red. His hat stays on his head.
He
asks us all the questions, and we know the answers. His heart lies in the ocean. His devotion's in the city of fun.
He's the captain.
He's the captain.
He's the captain.
The captain.
Hello, my name is Colin Aldridge, and I'm on the island of Jost, Dyke in the British Virgin Islands. Population 180 people. Me and my family make up about 5% of the population here. We have a little business called Jost Van Dyke Scuba and also another one called BVI Ecotours, and we're the only dive operator in this northwest out-island territory of the British Virgin Islands. And one of the reasons for that is we don't have any big hotels or any large resorts or villas or anything like that, just a few little places to stay. But we're known as a yachting destination, and we get yachts from all over the world, and this is a center. We have four major harbors. We have White Bay, Great Harbor, and also Little Harbor, and then the East End area. And our little business is a small business where we have a maximum of 5 to 7 employees and 4 boats. And we make a living taking people to the remote areas of the British Virgin Islands, off the beaten track. We basically pioneered this area 5.5 years ago and looked for dive sites and basically looked at a lot of nothing in many cases, but we found absolutely spectacular sites that go from seamounts, pinnacles, walls, reefs, to even a little shipwreck that we found off the island that's very exciting as well. My background is I basically grew up between Tennessee and Florida, a little bit of time in California, and then all of my adult life has been in the Caribbean between Cuba and Venezuela. I did yacht charters for all of my adult life, and I've gone through many passports traveling the Caribbean, and there's literally no corner that I haven't seen. Been taking people on adventure vacations, scuba diving, sport fishing, and of course diving. So here we are, we've got a little dive shop, and hope you guys enjoy Dive Zero. Good morning. Welcome to Jost Van Dyke, Jost Van Dyke Scuba in the British Virgin Islands. Welcome to a day in the life. As I understand it, you guys want to see what the day in the life of a Caribbean dive shop owner is. And we get started early here. There's a population of 180 people on Jost Van Dyke, but you don't see many of them up at this time in the morning. We're going to start out today with a 7 o'clock dive, a couple of VIPs, and then we're going to do the same thing again. So we got 4 dives this morning, and I've got a boat yard in the yard. So I'm going to be going off doing a little bit of grinding and just a typical day in the life. So we're going to get started out here, cutting up my coconut, starting out my day, and I get more work done before anybody else shows up for work, and then the rest of the crew does the rest of the day. So you guys are welcome to tag along. Nemo, relax. Caribbean coffee. All right, let's get started and get some tanks on the boat.
All right, guys, you came all the way from Canada to do some Wild Wild West diving, and we're gonna give it to you right now. We're at a site called The Playground. In 2005, this was voted the number one big animal dive in the British Virgin Islands. This is only one of 2 dive sites that we have national park buoys on in our territory, the Northwest British Virgin Islands. All the other dive sites we keep secretly marked with buoys right below the water. But this site is a site that's on the chart, it's one of the known sites, but the problem is that people don't know where to find it because the dive site's not where the buoy is, it's on the other side of the island. And the reason for that is it gives us a little bit of protection from the typically rough weather that you get on this Atlantic side of the Caribbean Virgin Islands. We're in open Atlantic here, And I know today that we're gonna be doing an exciting dive because I can see some pelican activity. Dove this site last Friday. We had some serious bait balls. We're expecting to see large schooling groups of Bermuda chubs, mangrove snapper, lane snapper, dog snappers. We also have passing spotted eagle rays and manta rays, Atlantic mantis from time to time. But we're definitely gonna see some big tarpon and a lot of varieties of fish. We've documented over 60 different species of fish on this dive site, and that's on a regular basis. On our way to the site, we're gonna be passing a gorgeous pillar coral garden. It's absolutely magnificent. One of the sites that all the magazines get a photograph of. And basically the dive site, which we call the playground, has been created from the massive seas that you can see from the rocks on the north side of the island. This island takes a real beating in weather. And there's many times we're out diving where this point here is totally being submerged under crashing waves, but the dive site is still diveable. On a day like today, conditions are 10 out of 10. It's gonna be spectacular. What we're gonna be doing is a maximum depth dive of 55 feet. And we're gonna be doing it as a multi-level dive. We're gonna be doing the deepest section first, which is 55 feet, but a majority of the dive is gonna be in the 35 to 45 foot range. The dive site itself is a series of several small seamounts, if you will, pieces of the island that have been broken off, that are out in the blue water, that have created the absolute perfect environment for these fish to be able to hide and sneak around. It's a very delicate dive site with every variety of hard and soft coral that exists in the Caribbean has been designated on this site and been identified. It's a very delicate site. It's a site we want to have great buoyancy control on, but it's because of it being a multi-level and basically what we would consider a shallow water site, we're going to get a lot of bottom time off of this dive. All right. If we are fortunate enough to see some predators, and that means that's the S word. If we're fortunate enough to see any sharks, just please let me be the person in front. We do this for a living and we know it's 100% safe, and if you can count to 10 when we see one, I'll give everybody their money back for diving today, because it never happens. If we do have a good experience, the general rule of the sea is anything that swims at you is trying to eat you. So therefore, if we do see a big sea turtle or something else that's really beautiful, like a Kubera snapper or a big grouper, you know, keep your distance from it and we can have a real National Geographic experience. If you swim at it, it's going to disappear, just like the sharks will when we see them, and I swim at them, you'll see they'll disappear too. All right, so we're gonna have a great dive. You guys know how to do the intro here. We're ready to get wet. We got some roseate turns, definitely got some bait balls. It's gonna be some big time diving. Let's do it.
Don't look back, it won't do any good. Or don't look ahead, you'll just be misunderstood. Everything you need could be right in front of you. It doesn't take much to see what is